there, morbid maniacs. It's time for another spooky video. And for tonight's spooky video, I'm going to be talking about a Japanese urban legend, of which I have talked about on my channel before. I did have a whole video on it, but I wanted to go through and make some of my videos over because some of the older ones were just a little bit cringy. Tonight we're going to be talking about Kushisakiana, better known as the Slit Mouthed Woman. The whole reason why I wanted to do this video over again is because of the whole coronavirus going around. Someone had posted on my Facebook that, they didn't post on my Facebook directly, but it was on my Facebook timeline. They had posted onto their Facebook a picture of the Slit Mouthed Woman, and it was with her wearing one of the surgical masks, and for some reason I thought this was the perfect time to remake this video over again because everybody is wearing the surgical masks thanks to coronavirus. So yeah, and I'm going to be doing something a little bit different at the end of this video, so I thought that I would, you know, tell you guys about the legend of her and also at the end try to recreate her makeup because I just love the Slit Mouthed Woman. I believe the first special effects makeup look I ever did was actually something similar to what she has going on. Yeah, this makes me really excited and happy, and I hope you guys enjoy. By the way, my sincerest apologies that Larry is not lit up in the background. His batteries ran out of his light, and I'm waiting until I get some new batteries before he's all nice and lit up again like Halloween. So yeah, I just thought that I would let you guys know some of my candles are running out of their batteries as well. Kushisakiana, better known as the Slit Mouthed Woman, is an evil spirit in Japan who lurks the streets late at night looking for victims. She is usually seen wearing a surgical mask on her face and carrying a sharp object such as a knife, a machete, a scythe, a large pair of scissors. In some versions of the story, she uses a fan or a handkerchief to hide her face, but in most versions, it's better known that she's wearing a surgical mask, which is the whole reason why I wanted to refilm this video over again, because the surgical mask just reminds me of what's going on right now, and I felt like there was not a better time to do this video. She usually appears to lone travelers late at night on the road. The legend states that if you cross paths with Kushisakiana, or the Slit Mouthed Woman, she will ask you a question. If you give her the wrong answer, it will have horrible consequences. She will ask you, "Do you think I'm pretty?" If you respond with no, she will kill you with her weapon. If you answer yes, she will remove her mask, revealing the horrible slit which is across her mouth from ear to ear. She will then repeat her question. Do you think I'm pretty? If you respond with no, she will kill you with her weapon. But if you say yes, she will give you a slit across your mouth, cut from ear to ear, in a way to where you'll look just like her. There are a few ways you can avoid the curse of Kushisakiana. One is said to answer her question by telling her that she's average looking, or to distract her with money or hard candy. Some people say you can avoid her curse by answering yes to both of her questions. However, it is also believed that if you answer yes to both of her questions, that regardless, she will visit your home while you're sleeping and murder you in your sleep. It is said that Kushisakiana was a woman who was murdered and mutilated in her lifetime. Now, there are many different versions of how she actually got her famous grin across her face. In one version of the story, it was believed that she was the wife of a samurai, and he had grown a belief that she was having an affair on him. as a way of punishment for his wife's believed to be affair, he had cut her mouth from ear to ear while screaming,
"I will paint your beautiful mouth."
In another version, it was said that she had gotten her grin from a medical or dental procedure which had gone horribly wrong. In one version, it was said that another woman had murdered her for being jealous of her beauty. And in another story, it was said that she has really large, sharp teeth filling her mouth. After the death of Kushisakiyana, she returned as a vengeful spirit, looking to seek revenge on whoever is unlucky enough to face her. During the Edo period, I hope that I'm saying that right, there were said to be a lot of Kushisakiyana reports and attacks in Japan. During the 20th century, these attacks were blamed on ghosts, serial killers, and just simple mass hysteria, which led to even more sightings of the slit-mouthed woman. The sightings got so bad in Japan that children actually had to be walked home from school by their parents or teachers. And the police in Japan even increased patrol late at night. So that to me tells me that this was actually something that was really going on over there in Japan. This wasn't just some made up story like some urban legends I believe are. I believe some urban legends are real, but some of them I do believe are made up. I do believe that every story like comes from something, but this story I actually believe in, like whether it had been a serial killer or an actual ghost, I do believe that there was something that was actually going on in Japan that made this whole legend come about. In 2004, South Korea was plagued by reports of a red-masked woman chasing children. So apparently the US has their own version of the slit-mouthed woman legend. Apparently, there were rumors about a clown who was appearing in public bathrooms. He would usually prey on children, and he would ask them one simple question.
Do you want death or a happy smile?
And if they would choose happy smile, he would take out a knife and slit their mouths from ear to ear. That was the urban legend of Kushisakiyana, or the slit-mouthed woman. I hope you guys enjoyed. Now I am going to do my own little take on the makeup of the slit-mouthed woman, and I hope you guys enjoy that. The first thing I'm doing is pinning back my hair so it does not get in the latex. Then I'm just applying some foundation. I should have actually did the latex part first. That would have been smarter, but I wasn't thinking and went ahead and put on my foundation on my face. Do it however you think is easiest. Then I'm taking some liquid latex and some strips of paper towel. I'm using paper towel because it's thicker and I don't have to keep applying layers. And I'm just sizing that to my face and tearing away the excess that I do not want anymore. And then I'm just applying it with some latex. And then I made sure that I did another layer of latex over top of that just to make sure that everything stayed in place. And repeated that on the other cheek as well. Make sure you let them dry before you do any more steps, by the way. Then I'm taking this dark navy blue eyeshadow and I'm just going to be applying that in the sockets of my eyes and kind of dragging it down because the slit-mouthed woman had very sick looking eyes. And I made sure that I blended that out more underneath my eyes as well. Then I took that same color and just added it to my crease of my eyelids and made sure I blended that out as well. This isn't supposed to look like eyeshadow, it's just supposed to look like we're very sick. Can't see that well because of the light, but I added a pink eyeshadow to my lower lash line to give it that red effect like she had. Then I took the same navy blue color and just added that over top of the pink to kind of smudge it out and blend it together. This is also to make sure that it's not too pink, and then I just blended everything out. Then I took a black eyeshadow and I'm just adding that to my upper lash line because she kind of had like a darker line on her eyelids, and then I just kind of smudged that out with my finger. And then I took a white eyeliner pencil and I'm just lining my lower waterline with that to make my eyes appear more dead and wider like hers. My apologies for the sun glare, but then I took some tweezers and carefully ripped holes into my paper towel pieces and tried to copy a picture of how her slit was on her mouth. And then very carefully I took some scissors and cut away the excess that I did not want anymore. Then I took out my foundation again and just applied that over top of the paper towel to hide the white and to make it look more like my skin. Then I set everything with a foundation powder. Took that same navy blue color and I'm just contouring my nose a little bit and also my cheekbones to make me look more dead like she does. Then I made sure to buff everything out. I also took it around the edges of my slit on my mouth and kind of buffed that around because her slit also kind of had, that doesn't sound right, I'm sorry you guys. It kind of had like a bruised look to it. I added more to the end of my nose as well. Then I took a muted red lipstick and just applied that to the inside of my slit. I then took that color again and just carefully applied that over top of the lipstick to make it appear darker and more bruised. And once that was done, my look was complete. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and become a morbid maniac, and let me know what you think. I love you. There you go. Let me know what you guys think of this whole urban legend. Do you think that this is real? Do you think that this was really a woman who was walking around in Japan? Since there were so many reports, it makes me believe in this urban legend a lot more than I would others. Let me know what you guys think, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a big old thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you have not already, and become a morbid maniac. And I will see you guys in my next video. Oh, also, stay safe. Wash your hands. Quarantine. We need to get out of this before summer, you guys, okay?